Today on Not News, we're exploring what exactly is wrong with Dom Terratet. I was trying so hard not to say that. Not only did old mate recently hold a COVID-19 press conference without an Auslan interpreter, meaning crucial health information wasn't translated for the 1 in 6 Australians potentially living with varying degrees of hearing loss and or deafness. But this traditional family first man, who is now Premier of New South Wales, gives almost everyone a lot to be truly concerned about. And if not you directly, maybe someone that you care about. In no order of terrifying, let's examine his family real quick. His brother, Jean-Claude, went to trial in the district court in 2017 for 3 counts of sexual assault on a Sydney University student at a St. John's College formal in 2015, after he was thrown out of an after party for being too drunk. Police claim they overheard him telling a family member that it was just second base, it was a bit of handwork. And he was found not guilty and is now the secretary of the New South Wales Young Libs. Jean-Claude said that he would never assault a woman because it was against his religion. Some are reminding the Terratet family that so is child abuse within the Catholic Church. Speaking of, Dom opposes laws to force Catholic priests to tell police if a priest confesses to child sex abuse in the confessional. He said no matter what sins are confessed. He then later said cover-ups in the church aren't great, but that the threat of imprisonment for pedophilic priests isn't either. How aren't more people insanely upset about this? On the topic of kids, in 2017, father of 6 himself, Dom publicly opposed same-sex marriage for the same Groundhog Day reasons every conservative homophobic politician has, saying it's a child's fundamental right to grow up with their own mum and dad. He also implied that these views aren't homophobic, while erasing the thousands of same-sex families and the implications such public statements would make not only on their mental health, but in schools, in the workplace and communities. Funny that children don't have a right to be protected against predatory people within the Catholic Church, but they do against their own loving same-sex families. Dom has also warned this country to stop throwing money at welfare, believing that it's the reason for divorce and single-parent families, not domestic violence, not alcohol and drug abuse, not financial problems or physical and mental health issues, not even communication problems or loss of connection and infidelity. Nah, it's all cause of welfare. He believes marriage is penalized and single parenthood subsidized by the welfare system. Again, somehow overlooking the rights and safety of kids who are living with a potentially abusive parent or in an unhappy home. 2 years ago, Dom opposed the decriminalization of abortion and was one of the most vocal opponents at the time. He acknowledged that some women fall pregnant in different and sometimes impossible conditions, and he probably should have stopped there, but continued to say that, "But our first response as a community should be to help, not to harm." A dash of critical thinking and empathy might remind Dom that help and harm are subjective, especially if you're looking at it through a religious lens. We know some people are gonna love and or hate this one, but Dom's wife Helen is actually a former Australian Federal Police officer and who worked in public relations for the Australian Defence Force. Lastly, but not finally, Dom's chief of staff resigned amid revelations the salaries of 2 of his personal ministerial staff were paid by the scandal-ridden insurance body iCare back in 2020. He's a climate change denier, and no doubt some people will admire Dominic Perrottet's unapologetic views, just as the Trumpies justify their love for who once was. But those views aren't reflective of 2021 and the people who make up our hugely diverse, problematic, but beautiful landscape. The only thing people are excited for, as history repeatedly shows us, are their wallets and his economic promises. So with all this in mind, and of course all the things that we'll never truly know, I just want to ask on behalf of New South Wales to 2021, what the f*** next? Like, for real, what?